Well, it's about it's called Nymph, and it's about two girls that come to Montenegro for a vacation, but they end up on a remote island with a fortress, and a killer mermaid is lurking below the fortress. So it's like a vacation from terror.
And you've got a fantastic cast, including Franco Nero, of course, well known to fans of the genre. Can you talk about how he came on board and how his involvement kind of shaped the film?
Yeah, well, I always had an idea to have somebody like a real known actor in a small role. And I was in a jury on a small festival in Slovenia called Grossman Film and Wine Festival, and he was there. And when I heard that he's going to be there as a special guest, I told the writer to write the character for him. And actually, he didn't really like it in the beginning, so he said, "Oh, no, I don't really do those small cameos things and stuff." But in the end, he said, just send me the script. He read the script. He said, "I don't like it, but call me." And when I called him, he said, "I have an idea to change my character. I actually like the story, but I don't like my character." So he changed a lot to his character, and I really liked everything he did. So it was really cool. I really enjoyed it working with him, and I think he was a big, big help for me and for the entire production.
Of course, you have some leading ladies as well. Can you tell us a little bit about all of them?
Yeah, well, Christina Klieb, she was in my first film, Apocalypse of the Dead, and we worked very closely. We were, like, enjoying working together. And when I had this idea for this movie, I called her and said, "Would you be a lead in my new film?" And she was really delighted, although I didn't even send her the script, nor the synopsis, nothing. I just told her it's a movie about two girls coming to an island with a mermaid. She was like, "Wow, I want to do it." And then I met Natalie and Ken, and I was on her birthday party, and I actually, instead of present, I wrote on a piece of paper that she will be in my next film, like a contract, you know. But like 2 weeks later, I was like, "Hey, let's call this girl to be in the film, because we were filming a movie now." So yeah, so that's how they got aboard, and it was really, really enjoyable experience. And the locations are really nice, and it was like a holiday with hard working, you know.
Of course, we're here at the Film4 Frightfest celebrating the horror genre. What do you think horror gives filmmakers and audiences that they perhaps don't get from other kinds of cinema?
Well, it gives them the opportunity to fight their fears, you know. I mean, I know when I was a kid, I watched mostly horror films. I couldn't sleep at night. And I still go watch horror movies at the end, you know. I don't know, I think it helps to overcome your fears. And for the authors as well, and also for the audience. And I think that's the reason. You can have a lot of fun watching that, you can be so scared, but in the end it's like a therapy.